Well, good morning, racing fans and fans of Canterpass goodies, and welcome to my review for Durbanville yesterday. Now, this is going to be quite an interesting review because there are a couple of things that I want to pick up here that need to be discussed and opened up. The rest of this happens basically in the second race. So let's start off with the first race where I gave her the Canterpass Goody Peregrine Falcon 10 minutes before the off. When I saw this go down to the start, he just looked like he's got some class about him. And the favorite, the 3-10 favorite, Fencing Captain, looked like a pure speed merchant. I thought from the draw, Peregrine Falcon could stalk him. He might be able to win, and certainly was a value at 3 or 4 to 1. We got 4 to 1 10 minutes before the off. He ended up shortening. But what was interesting was that obviously Justin Snaith said the horse probably would need it, and he hadn't galloped it, and that I think put everyone off. But when you see them go down, and I've been watching this all my life, I can see them go down. I thought, wow, he looks well, he looks fit, he strode out well, and he certainly was value, and that's what we're trying to look for as far as these horses are concerned. So let's have a look at the race, and that will give you an idea of what happened there. Well, let's go to race one and see Peregrine Falcon here. They're turning for home, and you'll find that the favorite, which is Fencing Captain, is in front, and he looks like he's got the race at his mercy here. What happens is quite interesting. Peregrine Falcon goes in, but there's a horse you should have a close look at, number three, Cork Bay. That goes right in, and Peregrine Falcon now goes. Cork Bay now switches right to the inside. Violent switch. Peregrine Falcon's now starting to get the better of the favorite, Fencing Captain. But watch your horse up the inside. This is a very, very nice horse. Right, we then move on to race two, where the favorite was the horse of Eric Sanders. And I'm going to have a look at this race and dissect it for you, because I thought it's very hard to say a man who's just ridden 370 odd winners in a season rode it badly. But this race begs some questions. So let's watch the replay of the race, and just a few things I want to point out. As this horse turns for home in the John Finlayson colours, the green and yellow, he's in front. He shifts out to the middle of the course. And then going through the 400, Foree looks through his legs, and the winner goes up the inside. And then he pulls a stick at the 200 and gives the horse a thrashing. Gives him three in a row on the left-hand side and three in a row on the right-hand side. The horse does respond after having pulled early in the race and running on, and got beaten for fourth. Okay, so we pick them up as they go into the bend. You can see that Majestic Majesty in the Finlayson colours is strong. He wants to go, and Foree lets him stride along. And he's just enjoying himself in front. He's got a wonderful action, this horse, and he's just enjoying himself in front. So now he's three lengths clear of them, turning for home and widening. Now, what happens in the straight is what really is of concern. So it turns into the straight here, and you'll see that Foree drifts to the middle of the course with him. Okay, he's still under a tight hold. And you'll see that Foree now looks between his legs. Okay, there he looks between his legs to see, and the horse drifts out even further. Now he's under a push, not a very powerful push, but he's under a push, and the winner has gone way past him, and everything else has gone past him. So then Foree starts urging him, and it's interesting to watch the replay, which will show you exactly what has happened as far, and he runs on really well at the death. So now let's look at the head-on, where I will explain to you exactly what I've said in the normal race itself. But the head-on is quite enlightening, and there need to be some questions asked. So this is well into the straight. You can see the horse on the left is the horse that we're talking about. He's getting a push, okay? Now watch what happens. For he pulls his stick and then gives him one, two, three, hard, okay? One, two, three,
hard. Then he just pushes him out. Another one with the right, then he just pushes him out. The horse runs on really strongly.
This ride begs three questions. The first is, when the horse turns into the straight, why does Fourie look through his legs? What is he looking at? The second is, why does he only pull the whip just before the 200 meter mark? He had from the 400 to the 200 to give the horse a real ride, and the horse would probably have kept running on to the finish and probably would have run a lot closer than it did. That's the second question. The third question is the vigor that he hit this horse with in the last 200 meters was really unnecessary once he hadn't given the horse a ride from there. Was it necessary that he should ride this horse in that manner? I thought it was really excessive, but that's my opinion. You tell me what you think in the comments below.